you're really striving for originality in your movement. And that's where the struggle begins, because you've only got two arms and two legs.
For me, it's just the freedom of the style of hip hop, because I'm very expressive as an individual.
When I lose myself in it, nothing else matters. I'm definitely classical and contemporary, but with a few other little quirks as well.
I like using hip-hop movements as a way of storytelling. But the challenge is to make it meaningful.
Bodies that move in mesmerizing ways, capable of the extraordinary. The muse and inspiration for a remarkable choreographer.
Dance spoke to me before anything else spoke to me. In my imagination, things move how I see them. I don't like empty steps, steps that have got no purpose and no meaning. I'm interested in why you're dancing. What are you expressing? What is the story? How can you connect with an audience through dance and make them feel something?
Kate Prince is a pioneering choreographer and storyteller, a dance maker for our times.
I had seen Sting 3 or 4 times live and was a massive fan. And I wrote this long email to Alistair at Sadler's Wells. P.S. I had this idea for a show based on the music of Sting. And then within a few months, I was sat in a hotel lobby meeting Sting and his manager and trying to pitch this idea of a dance show. There's such a vast range of musical styles, and lyrically, he's so poetic and he talks about the world. So it was really a really easy process to try and find this story that I wanted to tell. Every step you take, I'll be watching you. Every single day. And this is based around the idea of war-torn countries and refugees and displacement, and the global story of how that is affecting so many people. I think fundamentally it is about human resilience, but also to try and humanize a story about refugees that so often just feels like something on the news. So, you know, I'm not a politician, I'm a choreographer, but these things bother me, and it's an opportunity for us as a community of very international dancers and for everyone to feed in their stories about their heritage and their own life experience and create something that I hope is relatable. Choreography is beautiful to watch, and there's loads of choreography, but there's nothing that compares with a dancer making something live in the moment. And the tricks and flips and agility and strength that some of these dancers have is extraordinary. So, and that is very dynamic and exciting, and it always feels very fresh. But in addition to that, it's very much contemporary dance and breaking. There's also some house, some locking, some popping, some more lyrical hip hop styles. Everything's just responding to what the music is. The shows that I normally make, we write the music from scratch, and that takes years. So to already be in a position where I'm just listening to all this music and drawing inspiration from it, and it's such great music, it really is. It's for dance, it's just brilliant. I find the subject matter very upsetting. This is not a kind of laugh a minute show.
We all have some connection to family, so we can all understand what it's like when your family is broken by something that's not your fault. An outside force comes in and destroys your life, and how hard that must be, and the decisions people must go through to leave their homeland and to risk their lives in doing that, and the lives of their children, to cross open water in tiny little boats.
Okay, really
pushes you out of your comfort zone. This is based on a very, very serious matter. Mentally and physically, it's the biggest challenge yet. I'm now being pushed to a brand new level that I didn't even know was there.
I don't know what it is and it's not clear. So can you do it slowly with that rhythm so I can see where the steps are meant to fall?
I tried before to tell her of the feelings I have for her in my heart. Every time that I come near her, I just lose my nerve as I've done from the start. Every little thing she does is magic. Everything you do just turn me on. She'd marry me some old-fashioned way, but my silent fears have gripped me long before I reach the phone, long before my tongue has tripped me. Must I always be alone? Every little thing she does is magic. Everything you do just turn me on.
Central to everything, however, remains the music. With each story arc Kate's devised, taking its cue from Sting's songs.
Here you are, there's these songs which you love, and yet you've been working to adapt the music and play with it.
You can't just take someone's entire body of music and it just happens to tell you one story perfectly. It's been a massive collaboration to take this body of music and turn it into one piece of music, because it all needs to flow.
Kate's musical team for Message includes Alex Lacamoire, a multiple Tony and Grammy Award winner, best known for his work on the hip-hop sensation Hamilton.
This catalog for the show is so wonderful. It's all these songs that are so fantastic and songs that we know and love, but sometimes they need a little bit of extra touch in order to make a particular emotional story point hit.
You know when she goes,
yeah, yeah.
Because that would be a nice way to start building up our...
Sure. There is a motif that we have at the very, very beginning of the show. So I love the sound of that, and that has a very evocative quality to it. But what people might not recognize is that that's actually a message in a bottle. If you take it down two octaves and put it in tempo... So it's that, but taken up really high, with the fourth chord taken out. And there's the fourth chord.
He's been amazing. Some of the arrangements he's done, particularly So Lonely and Every Breath You Take, are so beautiful. And I always felt really funny about changing the Police arrangements. But with those two songs, they're completely new arrangements, and they're lovely because they serve the story. I think as long as it serves the story, it's good.
I think that's a better energy.
Yeah.